Hello students, welcome you all to next session regarding discussion on a general analysis of turbo machines, a continued part. In today's session, we'll be discussing regarding the head capacity curve for the radial output flow devices or effect of discharge angle or effect of the discharge blade angle for the performance also. So here discharge blade angle is equal to, that is the beta 2, which is lesser than 90 degrees, greater than 90 degrees or equal to 90 degrees. At different situations, what will be the performance that we'll be studying in today's session. So already you can see the email IDs which have been highlighted on the slide. You can send me an email to this email IDs if you have any queries, or also you can send me an WhatsApp message also. So with these things, we shall start the discussion of today's session as I am going now further. So as I said, the heading is the head capacity curve. The head capacity curve for the radial output flow devices, or it is also known by the effect of blade discharge angle on the performance. So the radial output flow devices are nothing but they are the power absorbing machines. That is generally the centrifugal pumps, blowers, fans. These are all nothing but the radial output flow devices. And in the radial output flow devices, the condition is that the fluid is entering radially at the inlet. So if you observe the inlet velocity triangle, you can see the fluid is entering radially, which means V1 equal to 0 and the absolute velocity at the inlet, which becomes equal to the flow velocity at the inlet, V1 is equal to VF1. So the inlet velocity triangle, it takes the shape of a right angle triangle now. Apart from that, many times the radial outward flow devices, they are generally applied for the centrifugal pump and centrifugal blowers, where the centrifugal term means the moving away from the center, which means here in these cases, the fluid is thrown away from the axis of rotation. Therefore, general centrifugal machines are known as the radial outward flow devices. Now, these radial outward flow devices are nothing but the power absorbing machines. And here, the energy equation for the power absorbing machine, it is generally written as E is equal to U2. VU2 minus U1 VU1 by GC, because we are writing it for power absorbing machines. So therefore here U2 comes as the first term, which is also equal to, in terms of it, that is equal to GH, or in terms of enthalpy, delta H naught is equal to E is equal to GH is equal to U2 VU2 minus U1 VU1 by GC. Now, this energy transferred per unit mass of fluid, we are writing it as E is equal to delta H naught is equal to GH, U2 VU2 minus U1 VU1 by GC. And we have already said that at the inlet velocity triangle, the fluid is entering radially, which means VU1 equal to 0. So when I substitute VU1 equal to 0, this term is becoming 0. And our energy equation per unit mass of fluid, it is written as GH is equal to U2 VU2 by GC in terms of head. This head is a thing, H is a thing, but it is a thing but the value of head, which is written in terms of meters. H is a thing but the value of the flow head, which is written in meters, total head. Now, from the outer velocity triangle OAB, so if I consider my outer velocity triangle as OAB, this one here, OAB, the value of AB is what? VU2. So this VU2, I want to get the value of this term VU2, AB. So this AB is the thing, but AB is equal to AC minus BC, which you can see from the outlet velocity triangle. So I want to get the value of this one AB. So in the AC, if I minus BC, I get the value of AB, that is VU2. So this AB, I write it as VU2. So from the outer velocity triangle, what you can observe is the value of AB, the value of AB, you can see here already it is there, there is nothing but it is VU2. Similarly, the value of AC, it is given here, the value of AC is the tangential speed at the outlet, that is U2 minus of BC value. So the value of BC is remaining for us. So for that, now I will take the another velocity triangle for BC. For BC, I will take the another right angle triangle, that is OBC. So in this right angle triangle, I will prefer from the right angle triangle OBC, I will go for cot of beta 2. So cot beta 2, I can write this as cot beta 2 is equal to what? It is BC divided by OB. So what is this BC now? This BC is equal to OB cot beta 2. And what is this OB? This OB is the thing, but it is VF2 cot beta 2 itself. So directly I will simplify this one and I will write this as OBC value as VF2 cot beta 2 using the right angle triangle. OBC cot beta 2 is equal to this particular value. Cot beta 2, that is equal to, we are having this one. So BC is nothing but it is the value of BC is nothing but it is the value of VF2 cot beta 2. Now this value, equation number 2, I will substitute in equation number 1, where the equation number 1 in substitution becomes as U2 into U2 minus VF2 cot beta 2 by GC. On simplification, I get it as U2 square minus U2 VF2 cot beta 2 by GC, or I can write this as in terms of discharge. So generally, the discharge you are writing it as Q is equal to the area of flow into the velocity of a flow. And this area of flow is a thing with what in terms of the depth, diameter and the breadth, pi d1 b1 into vf1, similarly pi d2 b2 into vf2, which means I can write the expression as pi d2 b2 into vf2i with respect to the outlet I am writing now. So that is the reason that I take it as pi d2 b2 as I am writing with respect to the outlet velocity triangle. So where this vf2 is the thing, but it is substituted as vf2 is equal to q divided by pi d2 into b2. D2 is the diameter of the implant outlet, B2 is the width of the implant outlet. Now what I will do is the value of VF2 Q, I am substituting this in the equation number 3 here. And on simplification and substitution, the equation number 3, it is remodified and it is defined as GH is equal to U square by GC minus U2 cot beta 2 by GC. This is the value of VF2, which we have just now substituted in this equation. This is nothing but the value of VF2, which was there in equation number 4, I have substituted in equation number 3. Now, I can write the same expression in this form also. That is, in terms of acceleration due to gravity as G, GC value is 1, it has been taken out. We are writing in terms of G, multiplying the G to the other side, U square by G minus U2 cot beta 2 by pi D2 B2 into G, or in terms of the terms, that is, H is equal to K1 minus K2 into Q. So here K1 is the thing, but it is U square by G, and K2 is U2 cot beta 2 by pi D2 B2 into G. So on these basis, we can write this as K1 minus K2, and using this, we draw one curve. We call that curve name as the head discharge curve, that is HQ curve. And we are drawing for the impeller exit angle, especially beta 2, with different values of discharge. So normally the three cases which you are preferring is beta 2 value less than 90 degrees, then beta 2 value equal to 90 degrees, and the third case as beta 2 value greater than 90 degrees. For all these cases, we are drawing the velocity triangles. Now, on these cases, there are three types of impellers for a centrifugal pump. One is the backward curved vanes or blades. Another one is the second one is the radial curved vanes or blades. And a third one is the forward curved vanes or blades. Now we will be discussing each of these blades one by one. The first case is the backward curved vanes or the blades. So initially in the backward curved vanes or blades, we define them as a concave surface which is facing towards the direction of rotation. And in these cases, always the tip angle which is there, it is with respect to the tangential speed and it is less than 90 degrees, which means that the value of beta 2 in this one, that is the discharge angle, it is less than 90 degrees. So when this is the case, we have seen there are two figures which are shown at the bottom. The first figure represents the outward velocity triangle. And if you observe this outward velocity triangle here, especially, you can see that the value of beta 2, it is always less than 90 degrees. If you observe here, the value of beta 2, it is always less than 90 degrees. So when this is the case, then cot beta 2 value always lies in the range of 0 to 90 degrees and it is always positive nature. So therefore, if you observe a second figure, that is figure number B, you can see that we have a plotted graph for the vertical axis as head and the horizontal axis as the discharge. So if you observe here carefully, as the value of discharge goes on increasing from the origin, you can see that the increase in the discharge flow rate, the value of head goes on decreasing for the backward winds. This is the case study for the backward winds. Similarly, if I go for the radial curved winds or blades, the radial curved winds or blades, here the value of beta 2, it is equal to 90 degrees. And when the value of beta 2 is equal to 90 degrees, if you see the shape of the orthodontic triangle, it is in this fashion, you can see. It becomes a right angle triangle and beta 2 value, it is equal to 90 degrees, which means the cot beta 2 is equal to cot 90 degrees and cot 90 degrees is always zero. Therefore, here what happens, whatever may be the discharge, if you go on increasing the discharge, the head will remain constant for any value of discharge. So therefore, the line becomes, that is parallel to the x-axis. So if you observe in the figure number D, if you see here, as the value of Q goes on increasing from the origin to the increased number of discharge, you can see that the head value is constant. It is nothing but a horizontal axis line itself. So therefore, you can say that for a radial curved vane blades, if even though the discharge goes on increasing, there is no change in the head, and the head remains constant itself. Similarly, for the third case, that is the forward curved vanes or blades, and here in this case, if you observe carefully, the value of the beta is greater than 90 degrees, beta 2 is greater than 90 degrees. So you can say that even though the flow will be less, there are some unstable conditions for the impeller, which is very much more tougher. And as here the head increases, so there also the flow also goes on increasing with the increase in the head itself. So therefore, here the cot beta 2 value, it is in a negative in nature. And if you observe here carefully, this is the shape of the velocity triangle. If you observe here carefully, this is the shape of the velocity triangle, which means the value of beta 2, it goes on increasing with increase in the values, that is 90 degrees. So therefore, for the forward curved blades, one more correction here, students, this value should be greater than 90 degrees. Sorry, make this correction. It should be greater than 90 degrees. Cot beta 2 value greater than, that is 90 degrees. It is negative in nature. And as a result, if you observe the figure number F, it is a graph for the head versus the discharge. You can see that as the discharge goes on increasing from the origin, you can see the head also increases from a certain point, from a certain height. So therefore, this is the nature of curve for the curved vanes or the blades. When the discharge increases, so also the head also increases from a certain point. If I combine all these conditions in a single graph, then the appearance, it looks like this. You can see here one graph, beta 2 lesser than 90 degrees. For an increase in discharge, you can see the value of head goes on decreasing. Then if I take the value of beta 2 is equal to 90 degrees, the head remains constant. That is neutral case. If I go on increasing the value of beta 2, you can see the head value goes on increasing. These are the possible cases for, or you can say that the angle of performance for the three cases, beta 2 lesser than 90 degrees, equal to 90 degrees, as well as greater than 90 degrees. In the next session, we'll be discussing some of the key hints how to draw the velocity triangles and the different conditions for the velocity triangles.